Good morning, RESkids, and happy Sunday. I'm Miss Danielle.
And I'm Miss Rennie. We are going to finish our unit on Jesus being both human and God. But first, let's stand up, RESkids, and get ready to worship our Father.
We'll be singing and dancing with the McCoy sisters to get our hearts ready to hear God's word. Let's praise the Lord together.
There's nowhere you won't go, nothing you won't do, no place that I could hide. You're always in pursuit. I'm never too far gone, always in your sight. When I wait for you, you're always right on time. You're always pursuing, always pursuing, always pursuing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. You made a way for me, opened up the door. Jesus, you have my heart, now and forevermore. You're always pursuing, always pursuing, always pursuing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. In me, you're always pursuing, always pursuing, always pursuing me. Oh, your love is chasing, your love is chasing, your love is chasing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. Oh. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. No, you're never, and you're never gonna stop.
I love the McCoy sisters. Their worship always prepares my heart for God's word.
Mine too. And today's lesson is super fun as we learn about the time that Jesus called his disciples to follow him.
In this Bible story, when Jesus is calling his disciples, it means he wants them to know him and follow him. RESkids, do you know that Jesus also calls us? Just like you can hear your family's voice when they call you, Jesus calls us too.
To make it simple, calling means he wants you. Jesus was asking his disciples to know him, love him, follow him, and trust him. Calling is Jesus inviting us into an adventure of loving and knowing him.
Let's take a look at this video and watch Jesus call his disciples.
Jesus' ministry had begun. He traveled around preaching about God and telling people to turn away from their sins. People started talking about Jesus and the things he was teaching. They were interested in what Jesus had to say. large crowds followed Jesus around and listened to him teach. One day, Jesus was walking along the Sea of Galilee. He saw two brothers, Simon, who was called Peter, and Andrew. Peter and Andrew were fishermen. Jesus called out to them, "Follow me, and I will teach you to fish for people." Right away, Peter and Andrew dropped their nets and followed Jesus. Later, he saw two more brothers. Their names were James and John. They were in a boat, fixing nets with their father, Zebedee. Jesus called out to them, and right away they got up, left their father and the boat, and followed Jesus. Jesus went on and saw a man named Matthew, who was also called Levi. Matthew was sitting at the tax office. Matthew was a tax collector. Many people didn't like tax collectors because tax collectors were unfair. Jesus called out to him, "Follow me." So Matthew got up, left everything behind, and followed Jesus. Matthew had a big feast for Jesus at his house. Many tax collectors and sinners came to eat with Jesus and his disciples. The religious leaders saw this, and they didn't think Jesus should be friends with people who did wrong things. They complained to the disciples, "Why does your teacher eat and drink with tax collectors and sinners?" Jesus heard the religious leaders and said, "People who are healthy don't need a doctor, but people who are sick do. I did not come to invite good people. I came to invite sinners to turn back to God." Later, Jesus gathered his followers together and chose 12 of them to be his disciples. Jesus's apostles would work closely with Jesus and would go out to tell others about him. These are the men Jesus chose: Simon, who was called Peter, Simon's brother, Andrew, James and John, who were called the Sons of Thunder, Philip and Bartholomew, Matthew and Thomas, James and the son of Alphaeus, Thaddeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas Iscariot. Jesus came to earth to show what God is like and to save people from their sins. This is great news. Jesus told his disciples to tell others about him, and we are Jesus' disciples when we trust in him. Everyone in the world needs to hear the good news about Jesus.
Wow, can you imagine being picked by Jesus himself to be his best friend and disciple?
That's like being picked to be on the best team ever by the most amazing leader ever.
That's exactly what that is. Jesus came to earth to show what God is like and to save people from their sins, and he called his disciples to share this great news.
Jesus told his disciples to tell others about him. We are also Jesus' disciples when we trust in him. Everyone in the world needs to hear the good news about Jesus.
And we get to be on his team, sharing it with the world.
Okay, I have a confession, RESkids. I love Jesus and love following him, but sometimes I struggle with obeying and following him all the time.
I do too, Miss Danielle. And the truth is, everyone struggles. Mr. Weber has a video showing exactly this. Let's take a look.
Yeah. Hey, man, how's it going? Hey, you know, me and my friends, we were gonna go follow Jesus. Like, do you wanna come with us? That'd be cool.
Oh, yeah, for sure, for sure. Come on in, come on in. Just give me a couple minutes. I'm gonna grab a couple things and get ready.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, yeah, I'll just hang out here.
Yeah.
Hey, man, what are you doing?
Dude, I can't go yet. I just enchanted my dragon saddle.
Okay, so you're just gonna have to hold on.
Whew.
Okay, well, we'll be ready to go.
Go follow.
Is that a guitar? You don't even play the guitar.
Oh, you know, I've just always wanted to learn guitar. So I figured if we're gonna be going, I should probably do this. You know, that way I'm ready.
Jesus, following you.
Hey, what's with the bag, man? We gotta go.
Oh, I'm just, you know, I don't know if Jesus is gonna have any fun, you know? So I just wanna make sure I bring some fun things, you know? Just have a good time.
What are you wearing, man? What are you doing?
I'm gonna finish, I'm gonna find.
What?
I want to be safe when I go outside.
What? I can't hear you.
I want to be safe when I go outside, okay?
Okay, cool. So you're ready to go then. Let's go follow Jesus.
Oh man, I thought you were ready. What's with the burger?
Oh, I just wanted to make sure I had some lunch, you know, before we go. I don't know if Jesus is going to have food there, so I want to make sure I get, you know, enough food. Yeah.
Where did you even get that? I was standing right here.
In and out. French fry?
No.
You know what, man? Just between you and me, it seems to me like you're just really into following all these other things instead of following Jesus. And we're going to go do that now. You want to come?
You know what, man? You're right. I've been putting all this stuff before following Jesus. Yep. Let's go. Let's go.
Awesome. Let's go.
See, RESkids, everyone struggles to follow Jesus all the time, including Miss Rennie and me. But there's good news, and it's found in the answer to our big picture question. Why did Jesus become human?
Jesus became human to obey his Father's plan and rescue sinners. Jesus is God the Son, and he loves God the Father. As a result, Jesus wanted to obey the Father's perfect plan. Jesus also loves people and wants to see us saved from sin.
God's plan for Jesus to die on the cross required Jesus to become human. Jesus wanted to obey God and save people, so he perfectly obeyed God's plan. Now, we get to be on God's rescue team to help others join his adventure of loving and knowing him.